Hi guys, this is Pestily and welcome to another Escape from Tarkov video. In this video, I'm going to cover the most recent Tarkov Live TV, which just happened. You had Nikita and Damirka in the episode. So I'm actually recording this as my chat's going, so hopefully they're interrupted in some way. But anyway, guys, without further ado, let's crack straight into it. All right, so they started off with talking about most servers around the world now running at a really good capacity, but without too long of server match times, except for North America. And they're going to increase the amount of servers by 8, and they're monitoring it. So that's all going to happen really soon. After that, they brought up the latest patch that's going to come out next week, so within the next 7 days. This one is a total quality of life with fixes and changes. There's not going to be any new content, but it's just all about that fixing out all those bugs and issues in the game currently. Following that patch, which isn't meant to be too far away, there's going to be a content patch. And in this content patch, it's a shitload of it, a shitload of things by the sounds of it. So they're working on the implementation of the new overweight system, which is going to have the comfortability and won't be able to run around when you're super heavy. There's more information going to come out on that on the next podcast. There's going to be a quick healing system, which is going to be happening straight after you finish a raid. You can pay a certain amount of rubles or rubbles, as Nikita was saying, and you'll be able to heal instantly. So you won't have to go and pick out meds to heal. You can actually just do it through a quick payment. They're going to implement the detailed death screens. So when this happens, so when you die, you're going to be able to pay to get information on how you died. And this will be based off the price of your level with therapist. So if you're higher level with therapist, will be a lot cheaper. And you can actually find out where the last bullets hit, how much, what caliber it was, and where like the killing blow was. So that's going to be a pretty cool system. I'm really excited for that one. It's going to answer a lot of questions when you die. And particularly the caliber. I think the caliber is going to be the best part of that one. There's going to be new clothing additions, a few new guns, but he wasn't sure which ones, as well as he stated the grenade launcher will probably be added. Now, this isn't the under-barrel grenade launcher. This is the standalone one. It's not the M79. I can't remember the name of it. I spoke about it in the previous podcast, but it will be in the game most probably. They're also doing a fair bit of overhaul to interchange with the lighting, which I think at the moment it's really bugged with how the with when you're using thermals, the lighting and interchange really screws with thermals. So it might have something to do with that. I'm not totally sure. But they're also adding new extracts to interchange, which is desperately needed, as well as the alarm to the Kiva store. So that's probably going to be the most interesting map to see after this next content patch. It's already one of the best maps for PvP at the moment. Their objective from this point onwards is to try and put out one patch every month. And then there'll be a wipe. When they stated in the previous Tarkov Live that the wipe would be around 5 months' time. So it's probably about 4 months away now. We don't have any more information on that from this podcast, but we'll go on with it probably around 4 months from now. The new patch info will be, a lot of the new content patch info will be available in the next Tarkov Live broadcast, which he said would be in about a week or two. So hopefully it'll happen soon after the fixes patch comes out, and it's going to feature streamers. It's not just going to be Nikita and Damirka. They want to do a lot of adjustments with the rigs and the plate carriers, and eventually the way they want to have it is they're going to have all the current rig setups still available to buy whilst they're having the new ones added. But when the game is released, every rig will be based off the new system for rig loadouts and setups. The question of Australian servers came up, and they are planning to add new Australian servers.
More Australian servers. Yes, it is. It's planned.
The Shoreline Scav boss is potentially in the new content patch. However, there is it's not confirmed yet, and his name's the Sanitar, so the Sanitizer. But yeah, so we'll have to wait and see with that one. They did talk about that in a previous podcast. I can't remember all the information for that one. But he is going to be either in the resort or somewhere else. I'll see if I can remember it, and I'll put it up in the text above. There was a question about scopes being overhauled, particularly with the reticles design. Some of them are either too large, too small, or not visible enough, as well as they're not represented properly as how they are in real life. They're going to work over the eye caps to actually make them relevant in the game, because at the moment they're more of a hindrance than a benefit to using them, and they're going to fix the variable scope sensitivity. It's in their prioritized list, but it's unsure when that's going to happen. Theme audio is currently, they're working on it now. However, it's a complicated task and it's still in like the research and development stage. They don't know exactly when it's going to be released, but at the moment they're trying to figure out exactly how they're going to implement it to make it work in the best possible way. Open world is still planned. There was a bit of talk about switching to the newer Unity engines as they come out, and then there wasn't much more information explained about this one, but they still plan to do open world. The next one was 1440p UI scaling. That's planned. It's the pretty much throwaway. Nikita answers some of these questions. The merch store is being tested at the moment and should be available really soon, which is exciting stuff. They're going to be selling cheese, socks, Demirka's phone, and a lot of other random items that they were talking about there, as well as baseball caps with knuckle dusters inside it by the sounds of it. Most of those were all jokes, but they actually do have some pretty cool stuff coming. I did speak about this one in a previous podcast review.
Merch store is being testing, and it will be available really soon. You will be able to buy special goods like my socks. Yes, my socks. His socks too. You will be able to buy like bread with butter and cheese, like some snacks. Also, you'll be able to buy Damirka's iPhone really, really cheap, like 5,000 rubles.
Now, the coldest are coming out this year. The models are all ready to go, and they're going to be focusing on carrying knives that will have poison on the knife. So when they stab you, you're going to die within minutes unless you have an antidote available. Cultists will be mostly roaming around the marked room areas and only around at night time. They're currently in the process of doing a total overhaul on the skill system, and they're adding two new skills coming up in the next content patch, being the hideout management and the crafting skill. This is going to make more efficient either, I think, like, I don't know, speeding up in either upgrading or potentially crafting items in the hideout. There wasn't really a lot of information on that one, as well as something about negative effects of stuff that happens in the hideouts will be reduced. Karma systems being worked on. The batteries are going to be added to the game, the new ones that you could see in an Instagram post on Battlestate Games Instagram showing the new batteries. They're going to be used in flashlights. There was a very brief moment where it said thermals, but it wasn't clear if batteries are going to be required for thermals, but hopefully they are in the future. Just to like break up that whole thermal meta that's going along at the moment. They're going to be adding the bipod mechanics when they add all the machine guns to the game. So that's probably still a while away. VoIP was brought up. Nikita really thinks that VoIP might ruin the immersion of the game. So at the moment, he's not sure if they're going to add it. He really likes the idea of having radios that you can actually contact people within the raid via the radio, but not so much just your standard proximity VoIP. They're still working on fixing all the folding stocks in the game to be able to fold anything that is a foldable stock. And they will be adding claymores and 338 Lapua rifles and guns in the game as well. He said maybe to English voice lines for bears, but there was no confirmation of that. I think most of the English speaking people want that because they want to be able to play the bear character but still be able to communicate with people. If they don't go around down the path of adding VoIP to the game, I really do hope they have a broken English bear or a broken Russian USEC speaker. I think that would just add some pretty cool stuff to that. It's doubling back down to the claymore side of things as well. With the claymores, they're going to be user designated. They're not like proximity claymores. So you're actually going to have to hit the claymore with their clacker yourself. There was a shitload of concept art, which I would hopefully have had now added to the video and playing throughout most of the video so you guys can see it. The concept art was all for Streets of Tarkov. Nikita said it's going to be the signature location for Escape from Tarkov, and a lot of the key events are going to happen around there. He doesn't know when it will be ready. It's a very complex map to be made, and the information is very in-depth. So there's a mixed houses on the outskirts of the CBD, which are the style of houses you see on Shoreline, as well as the urban environment of Streets of Tarkov being high-rise buildings. There's no skyscrapers in this streets map, but in the future, they do want to add a DLC which will have skyscrapers in it. I'll just go over quickly now the DLCs that we know that are planned. Nikita said there's going to be around 7 in a previous podcast, but the 3 that we know about right now is the skyscraper, which was just brought up, Scav Life, which is going to have a lot of additions to playing as a scav, like more like levels-based stuff, quests, and a storyline, I think, involved on the Scav Life. And then a snow DLC, which is going to include snowstorms. Don't know exactly how all these are going to incorporate to everyone else. I can say right now, if you've already bought Edge of Darkness, you never will need to pay for a DLC, or at least as far as I know. All DLCs are included with Edge of Darkness. So if you've spent that extra bit of money, you potentially will save money in the future. Now, guys, it was a lot of just messing about in this Tarkov Live TV, but it was very entertaining to watch at least. I was lucky enough to watch it during my actual live stream and, you know, have a bit of a banter with the people in there. There was Nikita showed a microwave on there.
You're happy! You're happy! Подогрей, хлебушка, блядь, подогрей, сука!
Which was pretty funny, and also he potentially might get the account banned again by threatening with a knuckle buster, that he took out of a hat that was plastic.
Plastic. It's not like knuckle duster. It's like plastic thing, like to reinforce the. Как называется это? Кэп-пэп. Кэп-пэп, it's just reinforced. Sorry, please, Twitch. Please. I don't want to go in jail again.
I'll add those clips in here so you guys can see it, and hopefully you guys enjoyed that. But guys, thanks for watching another video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, subscribe for future content. I'll leave a link down below to the VOD if it's still available and you guys can actually get to see it. But otherwise, I do live stream on Twitch every day of the week. So go to the link below, give me a follow there. If you've got any Tarkov questions, feel free to hit up my live stream or down in the comments below. And lastly, I'll see you next time. Remember when Alpha's not so old? Now looking back, Hit Reg just isn't bad compared to where we are, where we've been. I said we'd do it all again. Remember when?